As part of PESTEL analysis, understanding economic environment of country helps us in understanding market attractiveness. Various tools are being used by companies to analyze economic environment of a country. This session will help you in understanding various tools and how you can use them to determine attractiveness of a country which a company wish to enter. To understand economic environment of a country, one can examine the major macroeconomic indicators. Some of the macroeconomic indicators that can be analyzed are GDP, GNP, per capita income, which depicts growth of a country, inflation, and other indicators like balance of payment, external debt, etc., which depicts the surplus and deficit of a country. So what is GDP and what is the difference between GDP and GNP or GNI? First of all, GDP or gross domestic product is total amount of goods and services produced in a year within the domestic territory of a country. From the figure, one can make out that in India, apart from domestic companies and residents from other countries like Canada, Germany, USA, and UK are also having operations. Therefore, total goods and services produced within the national boundary of India constitute total GDP of the country. Also, annual average rate of change of gross domestic product of the country depicts the GDP growth rate. GDP growth rate helps in determining how fast an economy is growing. Now, GNP or gross national product is GDP of the country after adjusting net factor income from abroad. Now, net factor income from abroad is the difference between the income earned from abroad by resident of a country, say India, and the income earned by non-residents in the domestic territory of that country. In the figure, it is depicted that Indian residents are present in other countries in Africa, Latin America, Europe, etc. So if we add this income to GDP of India and deduct income of foreign resident in India, we get the total gross national product of a country. When we divide GNP, the total population of the country, we get per capita income. Another important indicator is inflation, which represents increase in prices of commodities and is represented as percentage increase in the change in prices from one period to another, usually a year. Inflation rate is high when demand for a commodity is more than its supply. Apart from having impact on cost of living, inflation also affects interest rates, exchange rates, and general confidence in countries' political and economic system. Now, some of the indicators which can be analyzed to determine surplus and deficit of a country are balance of payment and balance of trade. So what does balance of payment and balance of trade depicts? Balance of trade is difference between exports and imports. If exports are more than imports, then a country has trade surplus, whereas if exports are less than imports, there is a trade deficit. Balance of payment is a much wider term and is a record of countries' international transactions between companies, individuals, and government. For every country, there are various transactions which involve inflow and outflow of finance. Some of common examples of inflow are exports, investment coming into a country, remittances by nationals staying abroad, loans taken by the government, etc. On the other hand, outflow of finances is during imports, investment by domestic companies in overseas market, remittances by foreign nationals working in country, and loan given by government, etc. When financial inflow is more than financial outflow, there is a surplus. Whereas if financial inflow is less than financial outflow, there is a deficit. Larger deficit is an indication of weak economic condition of a country. Again, balance of payment is composed of current account and capital account transactions. Examples of current account transactions are merchandise trade, trade and services, income receipts or payment on assets, receipts on FDI, unilateral transfers, which include government and private relief grant and income transferred from abroad. Some examples of capital account transactions are dealing in real or financial assets and direct investment, purchase of securities, official asset reserves, for example, gold, SDRs, and foreign currency. Other indicators that depict surplus and deficit are external and internal debt. External debt is countries' total debt from commercial banks, government, or international financial institutions, corporations, overseas. External debt as percentage of gross domestic product is the ratio between debt a country owes and its GDP. Higher external debt means an unstable economy. Internal debt is the total debt government in a country owes to lenders within the country. High internal debt indicates excessive government expenditure than revenues and is a reflection of poor tax system, huge expenditure on defenses and welfare, sick state-owned enterprises, etc. There is a huge list of macroeconomic indicators which can be referred depending upon the requirement of the users. Unemployment, composition of GDP in terms of contribution of agriculture, manufacturing and services sector, poverty, literacy, etc. are few other indicators one can look at. Other parameter to analyze the economic environment of a country is to look at economic system. Primarily, there are three types of economic systems: centrally planned, market-based, and mixed. In centrally planned economic systems, production and distribution system is owned by the government, and all the decisions regarding production and distribution are taken by the government with the objective of achieving economic, political, and social objectives. In such economic system, state trading corporation participates in international trade. Other economic system is market-based, where decision to produce and distribute goods is taken by individual firms based on the forces of demand and supply. Individual firms participate in international trade in such economic system. Lastly, there is mixed economy where both private and public entities coexist. Both state trading corporations and individual firms participate in international trade in such economic system. By understanding economic environment of a country, companies can easily determine demand for its product, expected cost of production and net earnings, consumption behavior, availability of human or physical resources, network of infrastructure, fiscal, monetary and industrial policy, strength of external sector, repatriation of earnings, level of income and its distribution, tendency to consume, rate of inflation, market structure, whether market conditions represent monopoly, monopolistic, oligopoly, or perfect competition. Some of the secondary sources of information of macroeconomic indicators are international organizations like World Bank, IMF, United Nations, etc. However, companies can also conduct primary research to determine major macroeconomic indicators. Hope this video broadly helped you in understanding how one can analyze economic environment of a country. Also keep in mind that investment in knowledge pays the best interest. So keep investing your time and keep learning. And do tune in for more such videos in the area of international business. Thank you.